What's up, summoners? Kingler here. Today, we're going to cover the third team of the PvP series for RTA teams, and it's going to be control teams. So if you like the video, make sure you like, subscribe, and join the Discord server. Link for the Discord server is in the descriptions, as well as consider joining the channel for $2 a month. You can become a member and really help out the channel financially. But without further ado, let's get into the video. So as I mentioned before, this is part of the series where I go over all the different playstyles in RTA for teams that you're able to use and some general guidelines on them, kind of like an introduction series. We have covered Bruiser teams and tank teams, we also have covered cleave teams, and today, as I mentioned, will be control teams. So the way the video will play out, I'll give you guys an introduction, some background, some strengths and weaknesses, and then we'll move forward to some builds and then conclusions. So yeah, without further ado, let's just jump right into it. Now, let's talk a little bit of background on the control team and how it plays, some strengths and weaknesses, as well as some draft options. So control is going to be one of the most oppressive playstyles, and a lot of players really hate going against control because it makes them feel like they can't play the game. The way that it plays is by locking down your opponent or mitigating damage so much with debuffs that they are unable to come back and retaliate against you, and you're just able to deal consistent damage against them, killing their units while they barely do damage to yours. So very, very good playstyle, and will make you feel like you're in control of the game. So as far as some of the strengths and weaknesses of control. Some of the strengths, it's actually a really hard playstyle to counter. We'll see why when we see some of the picks, why it's such a good playstyle and why it's so hard to counter. You may be wondering, can't I just pick a cleanser? Can't I just pick a unit that puts immunity up? Well, that would actually require you to have two units that cleanse, because if you don't have two dedicated cleansers, they're just going to be able to lock down either ban one, and then they can also lock down the other cleanser, and they're forcing you to pick units that aren't going to be doing much damage if you're trying to pick three different cleansers. So it does make it very hard to counter if you don't have the specific units. So very, very powerful, and puts the draft in a situation where you're forced to do something that you may not want to do. The other thing is that it's extremely hard to wall them out. Why? Are they doing insane amount of damage? No, they're just able to outspeed you, lap you, apply so many debuffs, apply the slow debuff, which is one of the things they rely on the most, and just do consistent damage against you, and you're not able to use your heals, you're not able to use your cleanses, you're not able to set up at all, so they're just able to consistently do damage while they just lap you and you barely take any turns. Very, very impressive. The other thing is that they're in control of the game state at all points. You are trying to pray for some RNG. You are not in control of the game state at all. They are always the ones that get to decide what unit gets stunned, what unit gets pushed back, who takes what turn, and who does what. So the player who's playing control is in control of the game state and the fight. The other thing is, you can straight up just cheese wins from your opponent, even if they have better gear than you, or even just better, like stronger units or more meta units. You can still win against these type of players because you're just able to lock down their team with debuffs that they're not able to respond to you, even though their units might be super powerful and super well geared. If you can't take a turn and can't do damage, you can't win the fight. So you're able to cheese some wins because you're just able to lock them down. The other thing is that fights are relatively fast. If all your debuffs land, you know you're winning the fight, and the opponent knows you're winning the fight. They'll most likely either surrender, or you'll be able to do quick work with them since they can't really take turns and you're just killing them as you go. Some of the weaknesses of control, though, you may be wondering, how you just said all these things that sound super broken. What are some of the weaknesses? So the biggest weakness control actually has, it's going to be that it relies on RNG. If you don't get your debuff, you lose. Even the best control players cannot win all the games and will lose games that they normally would have won if they had gone Bruiser because they just had better gear. Why? If you miss a critical silence or stun or debuff or slow onto a priority target unit, you're done for. You can't come back from that. And like, if they have a cleanser and you decide not to ban it because you think you can lock it down with your Broman, and you end up missing the silence, that's GG. They cleanse, you lose, right? So it does rely on RNG very heavily. The other thing is that it actually requires very specific units to work. If you don't have these power debuffers, it's really hard to run control, and you're better off running some a balanced team comp with some control units as opposed to running a full control team. The other thing is that you are susceptible to getting outsped. This does happen because if you're going against cleave, You need effectiveness and speed, while the cleave player most of the time just needs speed. So it's a lot easier gear requirement wise to reach high speeds and not get effectiveness than it is to get effectiveness and high speed. So again, very, very hard and can get outsped. The other thing, again, this goes into just requires insane amount of gear. At the top level, the best cleave player in the world is going to have a faster unit than the best control player in the world. So they're prone to get outsped. Also, if your units are not well geared and don't have high enough effectiveness, you will get blocked out by high effector systems, the Annie, Rella Lights, the Stinas, Rays, all of that good stuff. The other thing is that it is a very limited champion pool. If you don't get these key units in your draft and don't play around well with those units that you're giving to counter different situations, you are actually going to lose the fight. So as far as matchup, you do win against Bruiser, and it's one of the few teams that actually beats Bruiser. Why? You're just able to remove their buffs that they so heavily rely on, lock down their team, and because Bruisers are typically on the slow side, you're able to lap them, do damage, and just straight up kill them, and they don't have a chance to come back because they have such slow speeds. The other thing is you do lose to cleave. As we mentioned, they are typically faster than you, so you're going to lose to them. And you also beat balance, because if you are able to get that critical stun, that critical silence, even if the balance player has taken two cleansers, which typically they won't be taking two cleansers against you, they will still lose the fight because they are not able to cleanse the debuffs, and you're just able to control the pace of the game, kill their damage dealers, kill their healers. So very good matchup spread, but again, the RNG really does hurt them, which is why it's not as popular of a playstyle. As far as draft picks, this will kind of start making everything make sense a little bit more. So the way that you draft is you need at least two strippers. You very heavily rely on stripping buffs from the opponent. If you don't have strippers, they can just have a very fast immunity seller like Emerald Crawl, Vivian. There's some other ones that I just can't think of off the top of my head. CC is another good one that have immunity gear and can set up immunity. And if you don't have a stripper, you're done. So you need two strippers. That's a requirement for any control team, at least two strippers. The other thing that you need is one heavy debuffer. Why do you need at least one heavy debuffer? If you're not stunning priority targets, if you're not taking care of the priority units, if you're not applying slow, if you're not doing all of this, are you really playing control at that point? At that point, you're probably just either playing cleave or you're playing balance. So you really do want at least one heavy debuffer. The other thing is you want at least one damage dealer. You want to end the fight to end. While your opponent is not taking that many turns, you do have cooldowns on your skills. And if you're not doing damage or taking out priority key units before those debuffs go away, you're going to lose. So you do need at least one damage dealer to actually be dealing damage. And of course, the fifth, as always, is usually optional, up for either counterpick or to help you out. Typically, this will be either another heavy debuffer, or if the team you're going against is very, very tanky, you are going to want to pick another damage dealer so you're able to lock them down. And there are other units that can fill multiple roles, and we'll go over that in a second. So as far as team cores, Broman is probably the most powerful unit that you have in a control team. If you do not have Broman, I am telling you right now, it is extremely difficult to build a good control team. Broman fills so many roles. He fills the role of a stripper. He fills the role of a heavy debuffer. And doesn't fill the role of a damage dealer, but is typically an instant ban for the opponent, which lets you have four picks that you essentially get to do whatever you want with it. So a very, very powerful unit for control, probably one of the best units. And if you don't have them, control is a very hard playstyle to play. I'm telling you right now, it is almost impossible to play control without a Broman, but it is plausible. The other thing is going to be Cerise. So if you don't have Broman, why is Cerise so good? She's able to strip and get the restrict buff, so your opponent can't take as many turns, as well as the decreased speed, making it harder for your opponent to actually play since they can't take as many turns, as well as having a S2 that can stun. It will make it so Cerise is able to lock down slow damage dealer that the opponent may have, or just continue on to a debuff that you already set up with another unit, which is just so, so powerful. And because of her high base speed, she's going to be cycling those skills extremely fast. You probably will get the stun every time your opponent takes one turn. The next turn, you probably already have the stun, which almost makes it possible to insta-lock or perma-lock one unit with Cerise. She is that fast and that powerful. Bazaar, of course, the king against buff teams and able to take off RNG to a certain extent. the pushback, they're unable to be buffed. And if you like the RNG, you can also not give him the tome, give him Abyssal Crown so he's able to stun. Right. Now, as far as the power options. So these are units that fill multiple roles and are just so, so strong. T-Surin is one of the best damage dealers that Control has, as well as one of its worst enemies, because she's not able to easily be locked down. So picking her up makes it so you have a really strong damage dealer that can also apply unable to be buffed, as well as silence, so you also have another crushing debuff that they have to deal with. Mula Armentia, who is going to get a buff, is going to be insane for Control teams. And if you have her, it's either an insta-ban or an insta-lose for the opponent with a 15% chance to win. Why? A full team stun with burns, she does everything. She's a damage dealer and she's a heavy debuffer that just really stops the team, and very little RNG in her kit, just a 15%, that's it. A Tawin, again, another unit that will destroy you but will help you so much. He actually lets you have a little bit of beef to your Control team, as well as applying a stun and a decreased speed. These type of Tywins will be faster than your normal Tywins, and I'll showcase some of these later on. Pearl, one of the best heavy debuffers and very easy to build. Arbiter Vildred just does so much damage. Also one of your worst counters, so you typically do want to pick it up as a damage dealer. The glancing debuff is super annoying to deal with. The damage that he's able to do is just astronomical if you have a good one. And just overall, just a very good standalone unit. And if you don't pick him, then you're probably going to have to ban him, because he can counter Control pretty hard. As far as damage dealers, Spectre Tenebria is probably the best for this, because she's able to hit two targets, do poison, soul burn for just destruction, just killing so many targets, killing one target at the beginning of the fight, as well as an S3 that's also capable of stunning. One of the best damage dealers you have for Control. Viseria, a really good stripper, as well as a really good damage dealer. Specimen says, if you're using Moonlit Aramanthea, it's almost a given you're going to be wanting to pick Spess, because he's going to be the best damage dealer pair with stun. Caesar Bellona, again, just so many debuffs, so much damage, so powerful, can do a lot. And Rylet, of course, if you control the enemy and you take out one of the units at the beginning of the game, an enemy that has one less unit is kind of getting controlled, right? So very, very powerful there, especially if you pick one of the counter picks that I'll show in a second. So Crescent Moon Ring, really, really good if you're going against anti-control or even cleave, because she has such high base speed. She's also able to stun and steal buffs from the opponent, so adds a lot of versatility to control teams. Wanda has a two-turn stun. It's absolutely ridiculous, and is able to hit Rylet if they do pick Rylet, so you do want to pick her there if you want to control the Rylet. F. Clary, probably one of the best counter picks you have as a control player. You can lock down their cleanser for two turns with the S3. That's just insane. As well as providing healing, as well as providing tank, as well as lapping the opponent. F. Clary is just amazing. She's one of the best 3-stars in the game and fits into almost every team. As far as other options, you do have Dizzy, who's very, very debuffs. If they don't have a cleanse, they're probably going to lose, because Dizzy is that oppressive. Sage Ball, some people say he's bad. He does lose to FCC, but you know, he does the job of a stripper and of a debuffer, so pretty, pretty nice there. Tenebria, a really good damage dealer, as well as a good debuffer. The sleep, the decreased defense, it's pretty crushing. F. Lytica, if you're worried that you'll get outsped. Kaoric, surprisingly pretty good for control, because you're actually able to soul burn and take out cooldowns of a cleanser, as well as do damage later on, since they shouldn't be doing that much damage to you. So it kind of takes away the problem that he has, that he's a glass cannon. Bonzasan, you know, has a lot of debuffs that can actually cycle pretty fast and are annoying. Mui, a really good aggressive stripper that if you wanted to go really aggressive with your team, you can definitely pick. And Dami, an actually pretty good solid stunner. As far as counters to watch out for, Champ C is probably your worst nightmare. If they have a Champ C, it's like you can't lock him down and he will kill you. So definitely watch out for Champ C. He's probably one of your worst counters. Assassin Cid, as we mentioned, outspeeding is really, really bad. Lilius, because she has immunity, she's adding more RNG to the fight. Same thing with Holiday Yuffie. They both are able to cleanse, and they both are able to add extra layers of RNG. H. Yuffie puts a layer with RNG at the beginning if you're relying on Broman. She just has a 50% chance to dodge. And then, of course, the most RNG is actually going to be Desert Jewel Bazaar, who typically does have the immunity buff that you have to strip, as well as typically having really high effect resistance. People have 230 effect resistance DJ Bazaars, and they're very, very hard to deal with if you don't know this, and relies a lot of RNG or needs or requires you to have godlike units. So you definitely want to watch out for those units for sure. There's many more that could go over, but that is it for this part, and let's move over to some sample. Alright, so as always, I like to show you guys some sample builds on some control units so you guys can understand kind of what stats you're trying to look for and why. And of course, I don't play control as much, but I do plan to actually play control because I feel like it's so powerful. And I am building a control team. But these are the units that I asked some of the people that do play control on my Discord to actually show you guys some of the units that they actually do have. So first, we have this F-Glory, who is just kind of insane, but really good for control. We see the pretty high effectiveness. It can still get walled out by some Deannies, but look at that speed. You're going to be stopping anything you want and just cycling your opponent really, really hard. So very hard to achieve actually these this stats, but it's not as hard. You can just put more effectiveness, less speed. It's not necessary for her to be this fast, but just kind of like a cool flex from the Discord. This Pearl, probably one of the better Pearls I have seen. And why she's so powerful. 210 effectiveness is going to be hitting almost every unit in this game, even top whale units that have high effector systems. And it's just going to sleep AoE them, and it's just so hard for them to come back from that. It is also very fast, so she's able to cycle, and you see her with Etika Scepter, because that does reduce the cooldown, making it possible for her to get her S2 before the opponent even takes a turn. It's just so disgusting watching good Pearls do their control things, and the sword is not even reinforced, and neither is the ring or neck. This is just insane. It's just such a good Pearl. So one of the better Pearls I've seen. A really good control spec to Tenebria. We see that she's on the faster side, and it's very self-sustaining with Book. This essentially makes her a big threat because the opponent is not able to take turns while you're able to do high damage and lap the opponent and soul burn for that nasty, nasty damage. The effectiveness is also high, so you're able to land stuns on some key target units and just control the team even more. Really, really good damage dealer. Probably the best thing that control has. Of course, I mentioned Arby. You don't want this Arby to be on the enemy team because then you will lose as a control player. When he revives, you're getting clapped. So definitely a unit you want to pick up, and again, pretty fast to make use of your speed for control teams and just able to lap the opponent. An effectiveness speed Tywin. We see that the speed is a little bit higher. The beef might not be as high, but the speed makes it so you're actually able to use him for stunning the opponent, since not a lot of units, not a lot of Bruiser teams will actually be able to outspeed his ambitious Tywin. So you're able to put them down, and as Frenzy goes up, if for some reason they do manage to come out of the stun, you're able to provoke them with the S1 because you're so fast. And if you get the soul burn, you're also able to just perma stun them. So pretty crazy a Tywin there. And then of course, as I mentioned, Broman is insane. We see an example of an amazing Broman right here. Extremely fast, really good effectiveness, will silence, will stun with Abyssal Crown, just absolutely filthy control unit. So powerful, able to just take turns and silence for two turns. The opponent is not doing anything for you to two turns. So again, you typically want speed and effectiveness in all your units and control teams, so you're able to lock them down while doing high damage and just lapping them over and over again. That is all I have for you guys today. I hope y'all enjoyed. The last one will be a balance, and it will be out later this week. It's one of the hardest things to talk about, the balance style, and I know that's the one that people are probably looking the most forward to because it's the one I use and a lot of other players use. So stay tuned for that, and I hope you like this one, and I will see y'all next time. Peace.